So, first of all, I just want to shout out my bestie, Erica, because I was near tears earlier on my live, and she literally, like, I logged off, and she literally called me and was like, I can't get the light. But she was like, oh my gosh, who do I need to fight? What do I need to do? But I just wanted to quickly come in here and just share, because I don't know if this is my gift. Like, I had a friend tell me this past weekend when I was at conference that I have a gift for just connecting dots and putting together things. But I don't know if it's the gift or if it's just the Holy Spirit that I'm just anointed by God. Like, when you're in it, like, this is how I want to say it. I don't think it's like, I'm trying to catch the light, but it's like not happening right now. But I don't believe that it's necessarily a gift of like connecting dots so much as it's when you're in alignment with the life that God wants you to be living, then the dots connect themselves because you're in alignment. So I think that's what the gift is. I think it's just simply, I am in the flow of God's like work that he wants me to be doing. So he's downloading things like boom, 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 boom. And so I'm feeling it happen now more than ever, that it's like literally everything that's happening in my life, I see like a teaching moment or a moment, like it's like, thank you, Holy Spirit type of moment. Like if you've ever seen a pastor preach and then you could tell he gets in a zone and then he just thanks the Holy Spirit for downloading, like this wasn't even in my preparation. Like that's what's happening. Like I've been preparing, having meetings with my content team, my VA, strategizing themes for the month. And I'm like, let me tell you something, like there's a difference between planning out content and then just letting God just move through you and speaking. So anyways, that's like a whole nother tangent. But quickly, what I wanted to share was, I wanted to just share how even just earlier, the story that I shared, that I was in tears and I actually didn't share here. And the only reason why I didn't share here was because I saw my daughter's like school friend log on, and I didn't want her to be listening to me share the story I was sharing because it had to do with her. And so I logged out. But even that story, I was just in the moment of breakdown, and I'm like, oh my gosh, if I'm emotionally attached right now, someone's got to benefit from this. So I went live and I just shared about it. But like when I was sharing, I thought I was just going to be sharing what happened and what made me upset. But all of these little like God moments came through, and it was like I was like speaking like truth into just how we show up in life in general and how it correlates. Like I took a moment of something that happened with my daughter and was able to come up with like three life lessons out of just telling that story. So then right now, I got the pictures back from when I was on TV last week, and I was thinking like, oh my gosh, like I want to just post my outfit. Like all I wanted to do was just post my outfit that my friend slash stylist styled for me. But then I realized like, this is how we show up in life. Like people will, and the story that I was gonna share with you guys, which is so funny, like the note that I do have, cause this is where my team is like, Crystal, you're so scatterbrained. Like you're so spur of the moment that it's hard to work for you. It's hard to work for me because I'm like, ooh, ooh, ooh. And it's like, I just get inspired and I'm not worried about, does this make sense? Is this in the strategy? Is this in the marketing plan? Is this in the scheme of colors? I just want to share it in that moment. And so, what's crazy about that is the two things that I did share today, this and then the live before this, that are in the moment, the lesson comes back to a conversation that I was gonna share. So I'll get to sharing this story at some point someday. But basically when I was in my lift, I'll share a piece of it. When I was in my lift coming home from my trip this weekend, the lift driver, I was just talking to him, and you know, it was like, I was asking him questions, which I'll save that for another day because that's a whole nother like story that I really want to give time to. But like it got to this conversation where he was saying what's wrong with Americans culturally, like not every single one of us, obviously, but what's wrong with collectively most of us here is that we have no values and no moral, and we don't have community and we don't have connection. He's like, where I'm from, like the village takes care of each other. Like if one kid's going astray, like the adults are taking care of them. Like we can't even discipline our own kids in our country, let alone in his country. The village is disciplining the kids. And so like I know many of parents who are like, don't talk to my kid crazy, don't touch. I'm the one that's like, I tell my babysitters, like, you could whoop my kids if you want to. Like we're just we're just different here. Everything's so like, we're defensive, we're territorial, we're to ourselves, we're inward. But yet, do you know what the number one killer is of people? It's loneliness. Loneliness is one of the top leading causes of death, because it's related to like suppressing the immune system into all these different things. So that's a whole nother tangent. But my point is, what one of the things that he was saying was the problem. I said, I was like, okay, this is what I do for like a living. I teach people how to take their passions and their talents and their gifts and turn them into a monetized movement. And I'm like, so you're driving Uber, you're doing all these things, you're working. And then I started asking him questions like, why are you doing that job? Why are you doing that job? You went to college for this. Why did you come to the States? What are you? And he's like, money. He's chasing money. So my vision, my gift is to help people stop chasing money and start chasing their alignment and their gift and their calling. And from that, God will overflow and bless you in abundance. But instead, people chase money. They chase the paycheck. They get a job that they don't like and they get stuck in the job and they're chasing money. And so then they're trapped in a hamster wheel where they have no fulfillment, no passion, no connection, just pure, I'm broke, I'm tired, and I'm tired of living like this. Or I'm not broke, I have tons of money, but I'm tired and I have no connection, or whatever. So when I told him that, I was like, you know, you should lean into this conversation we're having, because he literally was fired up, like, and you know, I know fired up, like his like neck was bulging. He was on the borderline of tears. He was talking like this, like his hands, like he was just like in it, right? He kept turning back. He's supposed to be driving me. I'm watching cars drive by us and they're like honking, cussing him out. Like he is focused. I'm like, that's where God wants you to be. And that's what I'm trying to teach people, is stop chasing the money. Start chasing like that thing that lights you up, like literally lights you up. Most people don't even take the time to unplug and ask themselves, what lights me up? They don't have time to think about that. And so what I was getting at by mentioning that was, I'm like, have you ever thought of doing this for a living? Like, have you ever thought of teaching people like how to have morals and foundations in their family unit? Or have you ever thought of being a motivational speaker? Or have you ever thought of mentoring people in XYZ? And he was like, no, you know what the problem is here? You know why I can't do that? Because people here don't listen. They think they know it all. They don't want to learn from other people. And I'm like, whoa. So I just thought that was an interesting observation of us as Americans culturally. I don't know that to be true because I do know that to be true because I do talk to a lot of people who tell me, I want your help. Help me have my best life. Help me do this. Help me do that. But then when I tell them, well, you're going to have to do this, or you're going to have to do that, or you get to do this, or you get to do that, or my suggestion would be, then they're like, oh, no, 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 no. So I experience it a little bit, but also because I'm surrounded in communities and mentors like where everyone in the, like, I'm in a parent group. I pay for a parent mentor. I have an energy healing mentor. I have people in the church mentoring me. I have a business mentor. I have a mentor that's just helping me get featured in the media. Like, I'm paying for leaders to lead me. And this is my point of the post that made me start this live. I'm paying for leaders to lead me based on what they know more than me. So sitting next to me in the chairs or on the Zoom or in the events when I go to them, when I learn from these leaders, are other like-minded people who understand that you have to invest in leadership to go where you want to go. It's like blind leading the blind. If you don't invest in yourself to get guidance and help for other people who have been there, who have done that, you're going to spend more time and money trying to figure it out by yourself or learning from people who don't know better than you will if you just invest the money and pay someone who's doing it. I pay for my business mentor because I don't want to pay the person who just knows, you know, a couple of more things than me. I want to pay the person who has the life that I have. So she is a wife. She is a mother. She is a businesswoman. That's the kind of person that I want to put my time and money with. That's who I'm going to learn from, because they're living what I want to live. They're proof of it. They're not just talking about it. They're not just saying it but not living it. They're being it. And so when I posted the post of just showing like the power, I was like, oh my God, like God, going back to what I started this conversation of God just downloading, he revealed to me like the very thing I'm pointing out with me when it came to my stylist is how people are living their life. I literally had my stylist come and I'm like, I'm gonna be on TV. I want your help. Let's go shopping. We went shopping. We got 3 or 4 outfits. They're hanging in my closet. And I was like, I will see how I feel that day. She's like, forget how you feel. This is the vibe of the panel. Like, these are the hosts. She's like, you're not going to this kind of event. You're going to this kind of event. So wear one of these 2 outfits. I started, like, as it got closer to start feel like, like, I know she said this, but I just feel like I should wear this. And I just feel like, and I started panicking, fear, all these little things, just being nervous started creeping in. And I started feeling like I need to go shopping again. So I went shopping again and I walked into Nordstrom. I only had like 30 minutes to shop and I freaking picked up this, this muumuu dress, which if you go to my recent post, you can look at it. Super cute. Love it. But it's what I'm used to. It's my comfort zone. I love wearing baggy clothes. I love wearing oversized stuff because I like to cover my body. I used to be like self-conscious of showing my butt because I feel like people would be looking at my butt. And then like now I'm self-conscious of covering because I feel like it's little compared to all the big old fake booties now. And then I feel like I have long skinny arms and I didn't want my long skinny arms out on TV. And then I feel like my legs are this and I feel like my this is that. And I'm like, I can't wear this. My boobs are too small. So I don't want a shirt that shows what should be cleavage, which isn't cleavage. So I got to wear something that's high on. Like I had all these things that I was just tearing down wearing my comfortable big oversized, just that it is what it is. And when I luckily reach out for help, and I promise you guys, I almost didn't get the help. I literally was like, I'm wearing this. I had it on and I walked back by my husband and I was like, I don't care what Clarissa said. I'm not wearing what she had for me. I'm going to wear this because I just feel more comfortable in it. Keyword, I feel more comfortable. So how often in your life are you going with what's more comfortable for you than what the person who knows better is leading you to do? And this is where we get ourselves mixed up, because it's uncomfortable to make an investment. It's uncomfortable to do a live on Instagram. It's uncomfortable to go do this. It's uncomfortable to go do that. And we won't listen to the person who knows better, and we'll revert back to, I'm more comfortable in this. And that was my exact words. And I didn't see it then, but when I went to post it right now, I was like, holy shit. Like, that's exactly what gets people stuck, is they go with what's comfortable. And one thing I learned that set me free, that I hope you can hear right now, that's very important, that changed my life, was I had one of my mentors who I do like past trauma like work with. She's like, do you know that humans get addicted to their trauma? So all of your past shit that's like sitting inside of you, that mental crap, you get addicted to that. So you get so comfortable with the crap that to see an opportunity for, to see a retreat or to see a program or to see a mentor or to see a getting on a show or writing a book or starting a business, to see an opportunity that would take you, see an opportunity that would take you out of that mess is more uncomfortable than it is to stay in the mess. Think about that. Like, we are more willing to stay in our shit than to go and get uncomfortable. And so my message to you today is that life is hard. Life is uncomfortable. It's uncomfortable being broke. It's uncomfortable being unfulfilled. It's hard and uncomfortable to be doing work that is not fulfilling. It's hard and uncomfortable to live a life that's not worth living. But it's also hard and uncomfortable to do the things that help you to get unbroke and to get out of your comfort zone and to live a life full of fulfillment. In order to fulfill, you have to fail. So without failure, there's no fulfillment. But it's uncomfortable failing. It's uncomfortable taking a leap of faith and taking the risk of being rejected. And going back to my live earlier, that's only on Facebook, or if you go to my story, you can swipe up and watch on YouTube. But I talked about how the one thing that is keeping people stuck, one of the number one things, is the fear of failure. It's staying comfortable because here I am still getting the lesson of how I almost wore the muumuu dress on my first TV feature, which I want to be booked on many stages, and yet I almost wore a muumuu that hides my power, that hides who I am, that hides me because of my insecurities, because I don't want to share my body, I don't want to show my body, I don't want to show my insecurities. I almost wore that because of my own comfort, but yet I have someone who is literally pouring knowledge into me saying, Crystal, I see where you want to go. I see your people are dying to have your body. You think this is that about you? People are paying for bodies like you. So I'm telling you, wear this. And I almost didn't listen to her. But like, as I'm looking back, I'm realizing this is what keeps us stuck. This is what's keeping most people watching this stuck. Because somewhere in your life, you're worried about what people will think about you, going to my life from earlier. You're worried about failing, going to 99% of the decisions we make. What if I fail? What if someone judges me? What if someone doesn't like me? What if I mess up? What if I'm not perfect? And because of all that crap, we choose to be uncomfortable in our uncomfortable shit instead of being uncomfortable, thriving forward, failing forward. It's uncomfortable and hard no matter how you slice it. So choose your hard, choose your uncomfortableness, and freaking go for the stars, go for the moon, go for the up and up, not the down and out, not the doing life alone and doing it on your own and thinking you know everything. So that's what I have for you. I just realized the time. I gotta go get my girls. Thank you, Jesus. Like, I give God the glory. First of all, me and my husband are fasting right now. We're on, I don't even know what day. I lost track because it just seemed like overwhelming to keep track. But we've been fasting since August 20 something, and we're going until the end of 2019, so until the new year. And we gave up alcohol, sugar, wheat, gluten. We're basically just eating clean, like fruits, vegetables, grains, nuts, seeds, things like that. And I promise you, if you are looking for answers, if you're looking for God to move through your life right now, give up something. You have to sacrifice. It's biblical. If you look at every breakthrough in the Bible, there was a sacrifice involved. There was a moment of stepping out on faith and committing to something and not knowing how they were going to get there, not knowing what was going to happen, being fearful of the unknown, but they sacrificed and they stepped out on faith. So give something up, give up your comfortableness and sacrifice something so that you can hear from God, so that you can really get clarity, because I have not been more clear and more focused in my life than I have in the last like month and a half, from giving up to God some of the things that I love the most, just to show him that I'm committed to whatever he's trying to move through me. And so I just thank you, God. I thank you. I give you all the glory for everything that comes out of my mouth, every piece of content that I create, everything that I put out here is because I'm uncomfortable. I pick myself apart. I don't like the way I look. Like, I try not to even look in the mirror half the time, but I'm here because I know that God is trying to move words through me for other people to step into their power and to be great. Because our world is perishing. People are lonely, they're isolated, they're unfulfilled. And I'm just gonna leave it here on a plug for, if you are somebody, because I'm gonna say this every time until November 15th, if you're somebody who has been looking at coming to the I Am retreat, that is not why I did this live, but if you're still here listening and you're somebody who is like, I'm ready to level up, I need guidance, I want to be around powerful women, I want to have 3 days to just unplug from my grind and to-do list just so I could focus on what is God really trying to do with my life, that is why I did the I Am retreat. And when I tell you God is all over this, it, like, I've been fasting for it, and everywhere I go, the word I Am is printed on something. All of a sudden, I'm seeing it everywhere. And I know that's just more because it's like, once you recognize something, you see it everywhere. But I'm taking it as a sign. And God, like, I lost my phone when I was on my conference this last weekend. I was supposed to be messaging people and following up with people and reaching out, because we're selling out and we're about to close registration for the retreat. And I wanted to do follow-ups, and instead I lost my phone. So I had no phone, no computer. And when I tell you the downloads that God gave me of the experiences that we're going to create, and that what I realized was, every day I'm committed to doing a live and talking about I Am. Today it's all about, I am committed to pushing through like being uncomfortable, having fear of being rejected, of not being liked, and going after who I'm supposed to be and having my eye on the prize. And so every day I'm committed to giving you guys content, because at the retreat, it's all about action. So if you've been to one of my events in the past, if you listen to my content, I talk, I have a lot of knowledge. I'm a wealth of knowledge, but I'm giving you everything here. I'm going live as much as I can, giving you everything I have. So when we get to that retreat, we're getting down to business. We are going to do the work. We are going to unplug for 3 days, and you are going to be off of your to-do list and off of your responsibilities as wife, as mother, as worker, coworker, friend, sister, whatever your roles are. We all are busy. People say they don't have kids and don't have a husband. They don't know how I do it. It's the same thing. Before I had kids and a husband, I was busy too. Like, we're all busy. So you're going to unplug from your busyness, and you're going to tap into the power of being surrounded by powerful women and mentorship of, what do I want? What am I really good at? What are my skills? What are my talents? What am I here supposed to be doing? What's stopping me? Why am I stuck in a job that I'm just chasing money? Like I said before, the problem is that people are chasing a paycheck and they're not chasing their calling, and therefore they're not able to create the life that they really love. And so you're going to do the work. You're going to leave feeling ready to take over 2020, ready to identify the tools that will help you stay unblocked and get out of your way. I have fear. I have all the things, but I know how to move past them. So you're going to learn how to move past all the things keeping you stuck, and you're just going to be freaking inspired. You're going to have fun. The fun is, like, I don't know which one I'm more excited about, the fun we're going to have or just the fact that we're going to be leveling the freak up, and we're about to, like, see women do things that they've never done before. And so that was, like, at the end of everything I said today. If you just joined, please know that this was not about my retreat. Go watch this video, because I really believe God moved through me and he wants you to hear some message of what I shared. But I am sharing about the retreat at the end here, because obviously it's like, anytime I'm going to point a problem, I'm going to always give a solution. So my solution right now that I can offer is, come to my retreat. And if you can't come to the retreat, consume my content, because I've got stuff for you jam-packed every single day now until we close cart for registration for the retreat, and even beyond then, because then I'm going to be really focusing on, it'll be off of out here, and it'll be in our Facebook group, so that the people who are attending, even if you're not, you could be consuming this content in a space where you can go and capture it. So if you join late, go watch again, because I do believe God has a message here. But I will just end the moral of my thing of, get out of your own way, stop thinking you can do life alone, trust other people to lead you, and really, really get out of the mindset that you know it all and that you are going to be able to do life by yourself, because you just can't. I just don't believe that God even built us. That's why I believe we have a longing for connection, because we were built to do life with other people and to learn from other people. And lastly, I'll say, if you are someone who was interested in the retreat, please, please, please DM me, because what we're doing is, we are almost closing spots. We've locked in the rooms today, so once they sell out, they'll probably be gone, because the hotel is, like, selling out outside of our room block. And I just need to get an idea, because once the month ends, I possibly might close it where we're at, so we can start on all the fun stuff. We've got styling stuff, we've got events going on, we've got the food, we've got the goodies, the surprises. So I just want to, like, reward those who are committing to themselves and taking action and start planning this thing, instead of being like, oh no, another person, we already ordered this, we already ordered that. It's like, no, if you know you're coming, at least DM me, so we can consciously be aware that we have X amount of people planning on coming, versus just counting people out because you're not saying anything. So getting your money right, figuring out your babysitter, getting your significant other on board, finding your friend to come with you, figuring out travel, whatever you're working on of why you haven't got your ticket yet, at least message me so we know you're thinking about coming. Love you. Have a good day. Have a good evening. And I will talk to you guys tomorrow.